In this video, I will discuss some system of particles problems. This is the first question. A small bucket of mass m kg is attached to a long inextensible cord of length L meters. The bucket is released from rest when the cord is in horizontal position. At its lowest position, the bucket scoops up m kg of water and swings up to a height h. The height h in meters is. You can pause the video and attempt this question. So initially the bucket of mass m is kept in a horizontal position, and then at the bottommost point it hits the water and picks up m kg of water. Let the velocity of the bucket before it hits the water be u, and after that the bucket with water, let the velocity be v. We can get this value of u using the energy conservation from this point to this point. So the gain in kinetic energy is half m u square equal to the loss in gravitational potential energy, that is mg into L. So this is the loss of height. Earth is somewhere here. So from this we get the u as square root of 2g into L. And the bucket hitting and picking up this water is like a collision. So you can write conservation momentum. So applying conservation momentum, the initial momentum before collision is m into u, and the final momentum is m plus m into v, and u is this one. So from this get the velocity v as m by m plus m into square root of 2gl, and let the bucket swing on the other side and reach a height of h. So again we can write energy conservation between this point and this point. So the loss in kinetic energy is half m plus m v square equal to the gain in gravitational potential energy, that is m plus m into gh. V is found from here. So from this we get h as m divided by m plus m square into L. So the correct fraction option is option E. This is the next question. A particle moves horizontally, collides with a fixed plane inclined at 60 degrees to the horizontal. If it bounces vertically, the coefficient of restitution is. You can pause and attempt this question. So initially the particle is moving horizontally, hits the inclined plane which is inclined at an angle 60 degrees, and after hitting it moves vertically up. So this is inclined plane making angle 60 degrees, so this angle is also 60, alternate angles, and it's moving vertically up. So this angle is 90 degrees, so this angle is 30. So we can write the momentum conservation. Momentum is a vector quantity. So we can write momentum conservation in two directions. One is along the plane, other one is perpendicular to the plane. So along the plane, the momentum, initial momentum is u cos 60 into the mass, and the final momentum is v cos 30 into the mass. Mass will cancel, so we'll get one relation between u and v. And the coefficient of restitution is along the normal direction. So it is final relative velocity minus the initial relative velocity with a negative sign. So final velocity is v sine 30 outwards. Let us take the outward direction as positive. So it's v sine 30. And initial velocity is u sine 60 inwards. Outward direction is taken as positive, so the inward direction is negative. So it's minus u sine 60. So v by u we can get from here as cos 60 by cos 30. So that's what we have written here, into sine 30 by sine 60. And cos 60 is same as sine 30. So you'll get sine square 30. And cos 30 can be written as sine 60. So it's sine square 60. So putting the value of sine 30 as half and sine 60 as root 3 by 2 and squaring it, we get 1/3. So the coefficient of restitution is 1/3. The correct option is option C. This is the next question. A body of mass 2 kg is projected upwards from the surface of ground at t equal to 0 with a velocity 20 meters per second. 1 second later, a body B, also of mass 2 kg, is dropped from a height of 20 meters. If they collide elastically, then the velocity is just after collision r. You can pause and attempt this question. Here is the solution. So initially the body A is projected upwards with a velocity 20 meters per second, and the body B at a height of 20 meters is dropped from this height, so the initial velocity will be zero, but it is dropped after 1 second has passed after the body A has been thrown upwards. So it will collide somewhere in between. Let the velocity of AB VA just before collision and the velocity of BB VB just before collision. So when the collision happens, let the collision happen at a time t. The distance traveled by the body A is ut minus half gt square, and the distance traveled by the body B is half gt square, because the initial velocity is zero, so it is just half gt square, and the time is t minus 1 square because the body B is being dropped after 1 second has passed. And SA plus SB when it collides will be this plus this, and it should be equal to 20 meters. So everything is known except the time t of the at which the collision happens. So from this, the time t as 1.5 seconds. This is the time at which the collision happens. So at this time, the velocity of the body B will be u plus at, u is 0, and acceleration is g, and time is 1.5 minus 1 because it's being dropped after 1 second has passed. So the time traveled during which the body B travels is 0.5 seconds. So it will be 5 meters per second, and the velocity of A just before collision is u minus gt, u is 20, and then t is 1.5 seconds. So from this we get velocity of A before collision is 5 meters per second. So when they are about to collide, both of them are moving with 5 meters per second and in opposite direction. So here we are using a standard result. There are two equal masses moving against towards each other with equal velocities. After collision, they will interchange the velocities. So velocity of B after collision, let me call it VB1, will be 5 meters per second in the upward direction. The direction will change. Similarly, the velocity of A after collision, BA1, will be 5 downwards. So the option A is the correct option here. This is the next question. Two objects move in the same direction in a straight line. One moves with constant velocity V1, the other starts at rest and has constant acceleration A. They collide when the second object has velocity 2V1. The distance between the two objects when the second one starts moving is. You can pause and attempt this question. So the first body is moving with a uniform velocity V1, and the second body starts from rest but has a constant acceleration A, and let the initial distance of separation be d, and let the collision happen in time t. So the distance traveled by the second object in time t is half at square because initial velocity is zero, and the distance traveled by the first object is v1at. It's moving with constant velocity, acceleration is not there, and s2 minus s1 is d. So s2 minus s1 is half at square minus v1t, that's equal to d. The velocity attained at time t is by the second object is at, and this velocity is given as 2v. So from this we get the time t at which the collision happens as 2v1 divided by a, and the difference in the displacements of these two when the collision happens is d. So here we can put this value of t obtained from here. So we get d as half a t square. T square is 4v1 square by a square, and then minus v1 into t. T is this one. V1 square by a is common. So from this we get the distance d as 0. So the initial separation between these two objects is 0. So the correct option is option A. This is the next question. A uniform rope of linear mass density lambda and length L is coiled on a smooth horizontal surface. One end of is pulled up with constant velocity V. Then the average power applied by the external agent in pulling the entire rope just off the ground is. You can pause the video and attempt this question. So the initially the rope is on the floor, horizontal surface, and the fold rope is at this level, and finally the fold rope is being pulled up So the rope will look like this and it's moving with the velocity v. So we can write the energy equation between these two. So the final energy equal to the initial energy plus work done on the system. Here the system is the rope. The final energy is the gain in gravitational potential energy. Let us take this as reference for the gravitational potential energy. So here using a standard result, if you have a linear mass density which is uniformly distributed, then the gravitational potential energy is gravitational potential of the center of mass. Center of mass will be at the center at a height L by 2. So mg into L by 2 is the gravitational potential energy of this linear mass distribution. And this thing is moving up with the velocity v. So the kinetic energy of this rope is half mv square. Initial energy is zero because this is the reference for gravitational potential energy and it's at rest. And the work done. Work done is power into time, the average power into time. The time taken for the rope to move from this to configuration, this configuration is, if you take the topmost particle of this rope, that particle is initially here at this level and is traveling this much distance with the velocity v. So this particle is traveling distance of L with the velocity v. So the time taken for it to travel is L divided by v. This is the time which it takes for the rope to get fully stretched. So from this we get the average power as mg v by 2 plus half m v cube by L. And mass of the rope is the linear mass density lambda into the length of the rope. So using m equal to lambda into L, we get the average power of this one. So it matches with option C. The correct option is option C.